Hi everyone, my name is Cassie and welcome to my channel, Bookish Four Eyes. I've been having camera trouble, so I've been using my phone recently and unfortunately the sound seems to be very quiet. I apologize for that, please bear with me while I get it sorted out. I'm not very good with technology, clearly. So this video is my review of a book called Every Note Played by Lisa Genova. I won this book through a Goodreads giveaway, which was a first for me. So thank you to Simon & Schuster for sending it to me to review. I just finished it today and I figured that since I had it fresh in my mind, I should probably try to do a review video. So here we are. This book is about ALS, which is Lou Gehrig's disease. Stephen Hawking had it. I guess that's all I knew about this disease before I picked up this book. If you're familiar with the Ice Bucket Challenge, they were trying to raise money for that. Other than that, I feel like most people don't really know much about it, at least I don't, so reading this book was definitely informative. And I feel like it provided a solid amount of information, really nitty-gritty in detail that I wouldn't have learned otherwise, so I appreciated that. With that being said, I gave this book 3 out of 5 stars because I felt like even though it was really informative, and I enjoyed learning more about this particular disease that I wasn't very familiar with, I felt like it fell short as far as just a regular novel goes. So, first things first, Lisa Genova has written another book that was really popular, it's called Still Alice, and I think there's even a movie based on it. So, if you've read that, you might like her writing. I wasn't familiar with her writing, so this is the first book that I've read by her. Basically, this is about a man named Richard who gets diagnosed with ALS. He's a well-known piano player. He's very talented. He's been performing with different orchestras. He's pretty much dedicated his life to it. He's in his 40s when he gets diagnosed. Also, there's Karina, his ex-wife, and they also have a daughter named Grace. Karina and Richard don't get along. They had a nasty divorce with some cheating and all sorts of things involved, so they aren't really seeing eye to eye, and when this diagnosis happens, they're not really communicating and they're not really on friendly terms. But with a crazy turn of events, as his health deteriorates, Karina becomes a caregiver for him, which is a huge responsibility. And she doesn't enjoy doing it, but she does it anyways. And basically this book kind of covers that, and I mean, there's not really much to give away, I guess, in terms of, like, spoiler alert, but that's basically the gist of it. So if that sounds like something you'd be interested in, definitely give this book a go. So now I want to start with the positives about this book. I liked the writing in this book. I thought it was very well written and it was an easy read for me. I wasn't ever struggling. The chapters are pretty short and I feel like short chapters make for a quick read, for me at least. And so I got through everything very fast and I was genuinely interested in the plot. It was moving well. I was never really bored. I was never like struggling to finish the book. So I really enjoyed that. It was very well researched, so Lisa Genova clearly has done a great job researching ALS, you know, giving us endless amounts of details and very technical details and all the equipment necessary to maintain a person's life and to help them move and to help them communicate and to, like, to help them eat and breathe and, you know, sleep and all sorts of things. So it was definitely very in-depth and it was very informative. And I mean, I feel like I learned a lot about a disease that I knew very little about. So I appreciated that. It's definitely, it's her second book about disease. I think her first book was about Alzheimer's. So this is the second book about a disease that, you know, really affects someone, so she's done a great job with that, and it really helps you dive in and to really get a good idea of what's happening to a person's body whenever this disease attacks. So I really enjoyed that. Also, both Richard and Karina are piano players. They're really into music, they're great musicians, and I think that this book also had a pretty informative look at what it is to be someone who is a musician and performs and, you know, dedicates a lot of their time to it. So I really enjoyed that as well. I thought it was very believable, and I was genuinely, you know, interested in what was happening. So I really enjoyed that book, that aspect of it. Now to the more, like, why I gave it 3 stars instead of 5. This book felt to me, and this is compared to Jojo Moyes' Me Before You, like in the back it says, like, as powerful as Me Before You. And I've read Me Before You like a little while ago, but I can still remember it pretty well. And I have to say that Me Before You is a lot more like surface level. It like is more about like people's emotions and relationships, and it's not very like technical in terms of all the nitty-gritty details of equipment and like percentages and like all that sort of thing, which kind of goes a bit over my head. So Me Before You I enjoyed more than this book because it was more like a novel. It didn't feel like a textbook, like too much information. So I feel like this book is kind of like what Martian was to me. Everyone likes The Martian. I liked it for how unique and interesting and just different it was, but I didn't like it for how like technical it was. I definitely appreciate that there's that much information, but on the other hand, it makes it kind of like it's too much. But that's just me. If you like The Martian and didn't feel like it was overbearing, this might be a good book for you. Another thing that I felt like wasn't really doing it for me is like the characters. I cared about them, but not that much. So like when Richard got diagnosed and his health became was deteriorating, I almost didn't feel bad for the guy. I just didn't genuinely connect with the characters. They felt a little shallow. Like I knew that they were into music and I knew that it was important to them and I knew how they felt and things like that, but I just didn't make a genuine connection with them. And I feel like for me, I have to care about the characters in order to genuinely feel sad for them and to worry. And like, I don't know, I just felt like that was missing. So I read it and it was interesting, but only because I was just thinking about it and like, what if that happened to someone I know or me or, you know, that sort of thing. Other than that, overall, it was a good read. Would I pick this book up for like a friend or something like that? Probably not. If it sounded like something you'd be interested in, then definitely give it a go. It was a solid read, solid 3 stars. Nothing too terribly negative about it. This book comes out on April 3rd, so if it sounded like something that you'd be interested in reading, definitely pick it up. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.